If you go down in the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down in the woods today, you better go in disguise.
I've bought myself some proper sort of professional traps. What I've gone for is the Fenn Mark 4 and Mark 6. So these are for small game, you know, rats, stoat, that sort of stuff. And the Mark 6 would be for a rabbit, exactly the same trap, but just slightly bigger. So what you do is you kind of set the trap, you spike it into the ground so that if you do catch an animal, it doesn't drag your trap off and you lose it. In truth, these are professional traps. They're all about humane dispatch, and the animal should die almost instantly. They've got a safety catch, and there's a little trick to sort of set in the pressure pad where you would put your bait. So what I've decided to do is to sort of go out in the woods today and practice setting these traps. Now, the aim isn't to catch any small game. The aim is to familiarise me with how these things work, how best to set them up, and just confirm to myself that they are sensitive enough to catch small game. So this is the Mark 4, which is quite small. Let's say it's about postcard size. And I've got a Mark 6, and a Mark 6 is slightly bigger. And like I say, what you would do with this one is you would be looking to catch rabbits. Now, they've got a safety catch on them before you set the pressure pad itself. But be under no illusion. If you get your hand stuck in this trap, it will break your fingers. You know, it is a very powerful trap, and it's designed primarily to kill small game. So don't treat them as if they're a toy. You know, these things are designed to kill. Like I say, if it does slam shut on your hand, you'll be looking at broken fingers. It's got a safety catch. Once you've applied the safety catch, then you can set the pressure pad. So what I'll do is I'll just show you how to do that. Okay, so this loop on the trap is where you put your thumb, and you take a full grip underneath the trap. So that's one side of the trap. The other side, you're gonna pull with your other hand until the trap's open. Now, just here, we've got a small safety catch device, and it's imperative that you get that safety catch on. You know, like I said earlier, if this thing slams on your hand, it will break your fingers without question. So now we've got the safety catch on, we can handle it in kind of relative safety. We've got this little trigger here, and what that's got to do is it's got to go underneath this little hook to set the pressure pad in place. And then obviously we're going to put our bait or our lure on the pressure pad, so hopefully the animal comes along. BLT is how you catch small game, and that stands for it stands for bait, lure and turd. So you get the appropriate bait for the animal that you're trying to catch. You want a lure, something to bring it here. So if we were after a fox, for example, perhaps bird feathers or rabbit fur or something like that.
Just to entice.
Catch its eye, so that it's inquisitive and comes over and has a look. And then, of course, animals mark their territory with urine and with faeces. So, again, you know, the animal may not see the lure, but it may well smell that another animal's been there from the animal faeces. So BLT is a really good tip for setting traps. What I'm going to do now is just set the pressure pad for you. So here's the trigger. We've got to push it down just a little bit more, lift the pad up, and now the trap's set. The safety catch is still on.
Yeah.
Now what we do is we'd spike it into the ground, maybe dig a small recess so that the pad is kind of level at ground level. And then we'd be looking at camming it up. UK legislation says that these traps can only be used in a tunnel trap type situation. So they have to be covered. And the sort of ideal is perhaps at the entrance to a rabbit warren, for example, you know, where it's just inside the warren, so therefore the trap is covered. If you're putting these out to catch maybe rats or vermin,
then again, some sort of box construction or some sort of cage has to be put over the top of the trap. And that's UK legislation.
All right, so what I'm going to do is just take the safety catch off of this and set it off and let you see just how impressive this could be. Okay, so there's the pressure pad. That's where we've got our bait. Animal comes along.
Ooh.
Traps us off.
Looks like the animals had a very bad day.
Yes. Like I say, they're designed to kill, to dispatch the animal almost instantly. If you get your hand stuck in this, it'll break your fingers for sure. So that's the Mark 6 fen trap. What I've got here is a Mark 4, exactly the same trap, just a little bit smaller. The other thing that I've put in my sort of little trapping kit, I've bought some 2mm wire. Now the breaking strain on this runs into probably hundreds and hundreds of pounds. What I've done is I've just cut it off into meter lengths. Now what we would do with this is either you could make snares out of it, or you could use it to tether the traps to the ground or to the base of a small tree. So you take your chain, you put your wire through, and then you tie it around the tree. The reason we're using wire and not kind of cord is because if the animal isn't instantly dispatched, mm-hmm. if it is still alive, maybe we get it by a paw or a limb and not its head. It's not unusual for animals to chew their way through any tethers that's holding the trap in place. So that's why you really want to lay your hands on some at least 2mm wire. The other use that I've got in mind for these is early warning devices, really. So you set your camp up or maybe even you're bugging in at home. You know, something like this in the garden could act as an early warning system. So what I've got here is a personal defense alarm. And my idea is to take your personal defense alarm, rig it up to the trap. So again, you just tether it to the ground at one end and attach by wire from your defense alarm to the trap. And then when the trap is sprung, now that tells you that somebody has set one of your traps off. It gives you instant warning, it gives you the direction of approach, it gives you all sorts of things. If you were to lay these in succession, so let's say we put two or three of them out, we can actually get an informed approach of any kind of intruders or unexpected guests.
Yep.
And like I say, all you could do is rig something like this up to a run-of-the-mill trap, and that gives you all the early warning you could possibly need. As always, YouTube, any comments? Love to hear them. Back soon.
If you go down in the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down in the woods today, you better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for certain, because today's the day that teddy bears have their pick. Pick, pick.